This is called the PROTECT protocol, what your dentist may not know about safe mercury removal, steps to protect the patient, the dental staff, and the planet. Did you know removing a mercury amalgam filling can be dangerous? It's also true that keeping that same filling can increase your exposure to the toxic element mercury. So what's a person to do? Well, first, do not allow a dentist to place a mercury filling in your or a loved one's tooth. Second, when you are ready, be sure your mercury fillings are removed by a dentist trained and committed to a mercury-safe practice. Mercury-safe means the whole dental team knows the right ways to protect the patient, the dental staff, and our planet. The patient requirements are a non-latex dam placed properly over the tooth having a revision. That means having the filling removed. A plastic-backed apron to cover the patient from head to toe. The face should be covered with only a hole for the mouth. All drapes are removed and disposed of immediately after the last amalgam is out. A new chest apron is placed to complete the revision. External air or oxygen delivered by nasal mask to reduce inhalation of mercury vapors or particulate. The staff. This means everyone that will be in the room during the mercury removal. Everyone needs protection. The requirements are a disposable or washable gown to reduce exposure from mercury particulate generated during the removal of an amalgam. These are removed immediately after the last amalgam is out. They can either be discarded or washed. If washed, they should be soaked in a compound called Mercury X powder before washing. After removal, a new gown is used to complete the dental visit. Face shields must be worn if not wearing loops. Eye protection must also be used. Hair covering should be worn by all and removed after the last amalgam is out. Either a respiratory grade mask rated to capture mercury or a positive pressure well-sealed mask providing air or oxygen are worn by the personnel. All disposables are removed immediately after the last amalgam is out. Hands are washed and new gloves and jacket are donned. During the maintenance of suction traps or handling of any mercury contaminants, personnel must wear full protective equipment as described above. A suggested but not requirement is using Mercury X cream on the hands and arms before putting your gloves on, and non-latex gloves are used possible. The operatory or the room used to remove the mercury amalgams needs to have adequate filtration and ventilation. High volume air filtration system designed to remove mercury is a requirement. A negative ion generating capturing device, a mercury vapor vacuum system placed approximately 1 to 3 inches from the tooth being revised. Copious amounts of water sprayed on the tooth to reduce heat and thus reduce the vapors. A high-speed suction to remove mercury aerosol and water from the area. A chunking technique is employed to reduce the drilling time. This means quartering the restoration in large pieces. Immediately after the last amalgam is out, all contaminated instruments are removed from the room and wiped down with Mercon or Mercury X. After the procedure, all contaminated areas are wiped down with Mercon or Mercury X. Suggested, but not a requirement, a cleanup suction tip on the end of the high-speed suction device. The environment. The requirement, a mercury separator to prevent contaminating the water and the environment. The IABDM supports clinical teamwork between biological dentists and like-minded health professionals to facilitate better overall health through mercury-safe dentistry, individualized testing for biocompatibility of dental materials, fluoride-free, craniosacral, osteopathic, and other body work for effective treatment of TMD and malocclusion, and elimination of dental focal infections. How do you find a mercury-safe dentist? Well, either go to our website on www.iabdm.org or call 281-651-1745. The International Academy of Biological Dentistry and Medicine is dedicated to advancing excellence in the art and science of biological dentistry and encouraging the highest standards of ethical conduct and responsible patient care. Don't you want an office that pays attention to all the details?